Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about thyroiditis. Thyroiditis is the general term that refers to inflammation of the thyroid gland. This picture shows the normal anatomy of the neck area. You can see the windpipe, and right in the middle, there's the thyroid. Look at the right picture, labeled thyroid. There are no symptoms unique to thyroiditis. If the thyroiditis causes slow and chronic thyroid cell damage and destruction, leading to a fall in thyroid hormone levels in the blood, the symptoms would be those of hypothyroidism, or the left side of this picture. If the thyroiditis causes rapid thyroid cell damage and destruction, the thyroid hormones that is stored in the gland leaks out, increasing thyroid hormone levels in the blood, then producing symptoms of thyrotoxicosis or hyperthyroidism, the right side of the picture. Causes. Thyroiditis is caused by an attack on the thyroid, causing inflammation and damage to the thyroid cells. Antibodies that attack the thyroid cause most types of thyroiditis. As such, thyroiditis is often an autoimmune disease like juvenile diabetes and rheumatoid arthritis. Thyroiditis can also be caused by an infection, such as a virus or bacteria, which work in the same way as antibodies to cause inflammation in the gland. Finally, drugs such as interferon and amiodarone can also cause damage to thyroid cells and thyroiditis. The course of thyroiditis depends on the type of thyroiditis. Hashimoto's thyroiditis, patients usually present with hypothyroidism, which is usually permanent. Painless and postpartum thyroiditis. These disorders are similar and follow the same general clinical course of thyrotoxicosis followed by hypothyroidism. The only real difference between them is that postpartum thyroiditis occurs after the delivery of a baby, while painless thyroiditis occurs in men and women not related to pregnancy. The thyrotoxic phase lasts 1 to 3 months and is associated with symptoms including anxiety, insomnia, palpitations, fatigue, weight loss, and irritability. The hypothyroid phase typically occurs 1 to 3 months after the thyrotoxic phase and may last 9 to 12 months. Typical symptoms include fatigue, weight gain, constipation, dry skin, depression, and poor exercise tolerance. Most patients, 80% of them, will have return of their thyroid function to normal within 12 to 18 months of onset of symptoms. Subacute thyroiditis. Subacute thyroiditis follows the same clinical course as painless and postpartum thyroiditis, with the exception of the symptoms of thyroidal pain. The thyroidal pain in patients with subacute thyroiditis usually follows the same time frame of the thyrotoxic phase, 1 to 3 months. Drug-induced and radiation thyroiditis. Both thyrotoxicosis and hypothyroidism may be seen in this disorder. The thyrotoxicosis is usually short-lived. Drug-induced hypothyroidism often resolves with a cessation of the drug, while the hypothyroidism related to radiation thyroiditis is usually permanent. Acute infectious thyroiditis. Symptoms range from thyroidal pain, systemic illness, painless enlargement of the thyroid, and hypothyroidism. The symptoms usually resolve once the infection resolves. This table shows the different types of thyroiditis, the cause, clinical features, diagnosis, and the duration and resolution of each one. Please feel free to pause the video and read them over. Thyrotoxicosis treatment. Beta blockers are used to decrease palpitations and decrease shakes and tremors. As symptoms improve, the medication is tapered off since the thyrotoxic phase is transient. Antithyroid medications are not used for the thyrotoxic phase of thyroiditis of any kind, since the thyroid is not overactive. Hypothyroidism. Treatment is initiated with thyroid hormone replacement for hypothyroidism due to Hashimoto's thyroiditis. In patients who are symptomatic with the hypothyroid phase of subacute, painless, and postpartum thyroiditis, thyroid hormone therapy is also indicated. If the hypothyroidism in these latter disorders is mild and the patient has few, if any, symptoms, then no therapy may be necessary. If thyroid hormone therapy is begun in patients with subacute, painless, and postpartum thyroiditis, treatment should be continued for 6 to 12 months and then tapered to see if thyroid hormone is required permanently. Because of the many different possible causes of the thyroiditis, even if we suspect this diagnosis in the ED, emergency department, we will not reach a definitive diagnosis. You will need to follow up with your primary doctor for more tests, ultrasounds, and referrals. If you have significant weakness, fatigue, passing out, any progressive symptoms or new symptoms since your initial evaluation, you should come back to the emergency department. For more videos like this video, please go to edexitvideo.com. But remember, these are educational videos and should never replace the attention or care of a primary healthcare professional. Please take a minute to like my video and to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.